you guys, welcome to Neat Made Easy, chapter number 4, Animal Kingdom. When you look around, you will observe different animals with different structures and forms. As over a million species of animals have been described till now, the need for classification becomes all the more important. The classification also helps in assigning a systematic position to newly described species. 4.1 Basics of Classification. In spite of differences in structure and form of different animals, there are fundamental features common to various individuals in relation to the arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of cilome, pattern of digestive, circulatory or reproductive systems. These features are used on the basis of animal classification, and some of them are discussed over here. Levels of organization. Though all members of Animalia are multicellular, all of them do not exhibit the same pattern of organization of cells. For example, in sponges, the cells are arranged as loose cell aggregates. That is, they exhibit cellular level of organization. Some division of labor activities occur among the cells. In cylindrates, the arrangement of cells is more complex. Here, the cells performing the same function are arranged into tissues, hence is called tissue level of organization. A still higher level of organization, that is organ level, is exhibited by members of Platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, where tissues are grouped together to form organs, each specialized for a particular function. In animals like annelids, arthropods, mollusks, echinoderms and chordates, organs have associated to form functional systems, each system concerned with a specific physiological function. This pattern is called organ system level of organization. Organ systems in different groups of animals exhibit various pattern of complexities. For example, the digestive system in Platyhelminthes has only a single opening to the outside of the body that serves as both mouth and anus, and is hence called incomplete. A complete digestive system has two openings, mouth and anus. Similarly, the circulatory system may be of two types, open type, in which the blood is pumped out of the heart and the cells. Out of the heart and the cells and tissues are directly bathed in it. Closed type, in which the blood is circulated through a series of vessels of varying diameters, arteries, veins and capillaries. Symmetry. Animals can be categorized on the basis of their symmetry. Sponges are mostly asymmetrical, that is, any plane that passes through the center does not divide in them into equal halves. When any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves, it is called a radial symmetry. Cylindrates, ctenophores and echinoderms have this kind of body plan. Animals like annelids, arthropods etc., where the body can be divided into identical left and right halves only in one plane, exhibit bilateral system, Yafit bilateral symmetry. Diploblastic and triploblastic organization. Animals in which the cells are arranged in two embryonic layers, an external ectoderm and an internal ectoderm, are called diploblastic animals. Example, cylindrates, an undifferentiated layer, mesoglia, is present in between the ectoderm and the endoderm. Those animals in which the developing embryo has a third germinal layer, mesoderm, in between the ectoderm and endoderm are called triploblastic animals. Platyhelminthes to chordates. Cilome. Presence or absence of a cavity between the body wall and the gut wall is very important in classification. The body cavity, which is lined by mesoderm, is called cilome. Animals possessing cilome are called cilomates. Example, annelids, mollusks, arthropods, echinoderms, hemichordates and chordates. In some animals, the body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Instead, the mesoderm is present as scattered pouches in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Such a body cavity is called pseudocilome, and the animals possessing them are called pseudocilomates. Example, Escalmentis. The animals in which the body cavity is absent are called acelomates. Example, Platyhelminthes, as in figure 4.3c. 4.1.5 Segmentation. In some animals, the body is externally and internally divided. Externally and internally divided into segments with a serial repetition of at least some organs. For example, in earthworm, the body shows this pattern called metameric segmentation, and the phenomenon is known as metamerism. 4.1.6 Notochord. Notochord is a mesodermally derived rod-like structure formed on the dorsal side during embryonic development in some animals. Animals with notochord are called chordates, and those animals which do not form this structure are called non-chordates. Example, Porifera to Echinoderms. 4.2 Classification of animals. A broad classification of animalia based on common fundamental features as mentioned in the preceding sections is given in 4.4. Phylum Porifera. Members of this phylum are commonly known as sponges. They are marine and mostly asymmetrical animals. These are primitive multicellular animals and have cellular level of organization. The sponges have a water transport or canal system. Water enters through minute pores, ostia, and the body wall into a central cavity, sponge cell, from where it goes out through the osculum. This pathway of water transport is helpful in food gathering, respiratory exchange, and removal of waste. Choanocytes or collar cells line the sponge cell and the canals. Digestion is intracellular. The body is supported by a skeleton made up of spicules or spongin fibers. Sexes are not separate. Hermaphrodite, that is, eggs and sperms are produced by the same individual. Sponges reproduce asexually by fragmentation and sexually by the formation of gametes. Fertilization is internal and development is indirect, having a larval stage which is morphologically distinct from the adult. Examples, Cycons, Scypha, Spongula, Freshwater Sponge, and Eusporangia or Bat Sponge. Phylum Cylindrata or Cnidaria. They are aquatic, mostly marine, sessile or free-swimming, radially symmetrical animals. The name Cnidaria is derived from its nidoblast or nidocyst, which contain the stinging capsules or nematocyst present in the tentacles and the body. Nidoblasts are used for anchorage, defense, and for the capture of prey. Cnidarians exhibit tissue level of organization and are diploblastic. They have a central gastrovascular cavity with a single opening mouth on hypostome. Digestion is extracellular and intracellular. Some of the cnidarians, example corals, have a skeleton composed of calcium carbonate. Cnidarians exhibit two basic body forms called polyp and medusa. The former is a sessile and cylindrical form like Hydra, Adamantia, whereas the latter is umbrella-shaped and free-swimming like Aurelia or jellyfish. Those cnidarians which exist in both forms exhibit alternation of generation, metagenesis. Polyps produce medusae asexually and medusae forms the polyps sexually. Example in Abelia. Examples, Physalia, Portuguese, Man of War, Adamantia, Sea Anemone, Pinnatula, Sea Pen, Gorgonia, Sea Fan, and Meandrina, Brain Coral. 4.2.3 Phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophores, commonly known as sea walnuts or comedrillids, are exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic organisms with tissue level of organization. The body bears 8 external rows of ciliated complex which help in the locomotion. Digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. Bioluminescence, the property of a living organism to emit light, is well marked in Ctenophores. Sexes are not separate. Reproduction takes place only by sexual means. Fertilization is external with indirect development. Examples in Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. 4.2.4 Phylum Platyhelminthes. They have dorso-ventrally flattened body, hence are called flatworms. These are mostly endoparasites found in animals, including human beings. Flatworms are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and acoelomate animals with organ level of organization. Hooks and suckers are present in the parasite worms. Some of them absorb nutrients from the host directly through their body surface. Specialized cells called flame cells help in osmoregulation and excretion. Sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal and development is through many larval stages. Some members like Planaria possess high regeneration capacity. Example, Stenia, tapeworm, fasciola, liver fluke. 4.2.5 Phylum Escalmentis. The body of the Escalmentis is circular in cross section. Hence the name roundworms. They may be free living, aquatic, and terrestrial or parasitic in plants and animals. Roundworms have organ system level of body organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and pseudocoelomate animals. Alimentary canal is complete with a well-developed muscular pharynx. An excretory tube removes body waste from the body cavity through the excretory pore. Sexes are separate. Dioecious, that is, males and females are distinct. Often females are longer than males. Fertilization is internal and development may be direct. The young ones resemble the adult or indirect. Examples: Ascaris roundworm, Wicheria filaria worm, Encyclostomata hookworm. 4.2.6 Phylum Annelida. They may be aquatic, marine or freshwater or terrestrial, free living and sometimes parasitic. They exhibit organ system level of body organization and bilateral symmetrical. They are triploblastic, metamedically segmented and coelomate animals. Their body surface is distinctly marked out into segments or metameres, and hence the phylum name Annelida, Latin annulus, little ring. Figure 4.11. They possess longitudinal and circular muscles which help in locomotion. Aquatic annelids like nereids possess lateral appendages, parapodia, which help in swimming. A closed circulatory system is present. Nephridia, single nephridium, help in osmoregulation and excretion. Neural system consists of paired ganglia, singular ganglion, connected by lateral nerves into a double ventral nerve cord. Nereids is an aquatic form, is dioecious, but earthworms and leeches are monoecious, reproduction is sexual. Examples: Nereis, Ferritema, earthworm, and Hirudinaria, blood-sucking leech. 4.2.7 Phylum Arthropoda. This is the largest phylum of Annelida, Animalia, which includes insects. Over two-thirds of all named species on Earth are arthropods. Figure 4.12. They have organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, segmented, and coelomate animals. The body of arthropods is covered by chitinous exoskeleton. The body consists of head, thorax, and abdomen. They have jointed appendages, anthrax joint, and poda means appendages. Respiratory organs are gills, bug lungs, or a tracheal system. Circulatory system of open type is seen. Sensory organs like antennae, eyes, compound and simple statocyst or balancing organs are present. Excretion takes place through malphigian tubules. They are mostly dioecious. Fertilization is usually internal. They are mostly oviparous. Development may be direct or indirect. Examples: economically important insects, Apis honeybee, Bombyx silkworm, Lassifer, Lac insect, vectors, Anopheles, Culex, and Aedes mosquito, gregarious pest, locusta or locust, living fossil, Limulus, or king crab. 4.2.8 Phylum Mollusca. This is the second largest animal phylum. Figure 4.13. Mollusca are terrestrial or aquatic, marine or freshwater, having an organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and coelomate animals. Body is covered by calcareous shell and is unsegmented with a distinct head, muscular foot, and a visceral hump. A soft and spongy layer of skin forms a mantle over the visceral hump. The space between the hump and the mantle is called a mantle cavity, in which feather-like gills are present. They have respiratory and excretory functions. The anterior head region has sensory tentacles. The mouth contains a file-like rasping organ for feeding called radula. They are usually dioecious and oviparous with indirect development. Examples: Pila, apple snail, pink tada, peel oyster, sepia, cuttlefish, loligo, squid, octopus, devilfish, aplysia, sea hare, dendritium, tusk shell, and Ketopleura, chiton. 4.2.9 Phylum Echinodermata. These animals have an endoskeleton of calcareous ossicles and hence the name Echinodermata. Spiny bodied. Figure 4.14. All are marine with organ system level of organization. The adult echinoderms are radially symmetrical, but larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic and coelomate animals. Digestive system is complete with mouth on the lower ventral side and anus on the upper dorsal side. The mouth distinct features of the echinoderms is the presence of water vascular system, which helps in locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. An excretory system is absent. Sexes are separate. Reproduction is sexual. Fertilization is usually external. Development is indirect with free swimming larva. Examples: Asteria, starfish, Echinus, sea urchin, Entidon, sea lily, Cucumeria, sea cucumber, and Ophiuria, brittle star. 4.2.10 Phylum Hemichordata. Hemichordata was earlier considered a subphylum under phylum Chordata, but now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata. Hemichordates have a rudimentary structure in the collar region called stomachord, a structure similar to notochord. This phylum consists of a small group of worm-like marine animals with organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and coelomate animals. The body is cylindrical and is composed of an anterior proboscis, a collar, and a long trunk. Circulatory system is of open type. Respiratory takes respiration takes place through gills. Excretory organ is proboscis gland. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external and development is indirect. Examples: balanoglossus and sacoglossus. 4.2.11 Phylum Chordata. Animals belonging to phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of a notochord, a dorsal hollow nerve cord, and a paired pharyngeal gill slits. These are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and coelomate with organ system level of organization. Deposits a post-anal tail and a closed circulatory system. 4.1 Parents presents a comparison of salient features of chordates and non-chordates. Phylum Chordata is divided into three subphyla, Urochordata or Tunicata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Subphylum Urochordata and Cephalochordata are often referred to as protochordates, figure 4.17, and are exclusively marine. In Urochordata, notochord is present only in larval tail, while in Cephalochordata, it extends from head to tail region and is persistent throughout their life. Examples: Urochordata, Ascidia, Scalpa, Doliolum, Cephalochordata, Branchiostoma, Amphioxus, or Lancelet. The members of subphylum Vertebrata possess notochord during the embryonic period. The notochord is replaced by the cartilaginous or bony vertebral column in the adult. Thus, all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Besides the basic chordate characters, the vertebrates have a ventral muscular heart with two or three or four chambers, kidneys for excretion and osmoregulation, and paired appendages which may be fins or limbs. Let's move on to this table. In chordates, notochord is present. In non-chordates, notochord is absent. Now, in chordates, central nervous system is dorsal, hollow, and single. Pharynx is perforated by gill slits. Heart is ventral, and post-anal part tail is present. In non-chordates, central nervous system is ventral, solid, and double. Gill slits are absent. Heart is dorsal if present, and post-anal tail is absent. The subphylum Vertebrata is further divided as follows. Vertebrata is divided into Agantha that lacks jaw and Gnathostomata that bears jaw. Gnathostomata is a superclass which is divided into Pieces and Tetrapoda, and Agantha divides into class Cyclostomata. 4.2.11.1 Class Cyclostomata. All living members of the class Cyclostomata are ectoparasites on some fishes. They have an elongated body bearing 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits for respiration. Cyclostomes have a sucking and circular mouth without jaws. Figure 4.18. Deer body is devoid of scales and paired fins. Cranium and vertebral column are cartilaginous. Circulation is of closed type. Cyclostomes are marine but migrate for spawning to freshwater. After spawning, within a few days, they die. Their larvae, after metamorphosis, return to the ocean. Examples: Petromyzon, Lamprey, and Maxine, hagfish. 4.2.11.2 Class Chondrichthyes. They are marine animals with streamlined bodies and have cartilaginous endoskeleton. Figure 4.19. Mouth is located ventrally. Notochord is persistent throughout the life. Gill slits are separate and without operculum. Gill cover. The skin is tough, containing minute placoid scales. Teeth are modified placoid scales which are backwardly directed. Their jaws are very powerful. These animals are predaceous. Due to the absence of air bladder, they have to swim constantly to avoid sinking. Heart is two-chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. Some of them have electric organs, example torpedo, and some possess poison sting, example trigon. They are cold-blooded poikilothermous animals. They lack the capacity to regulate their body temperature. Sexes are separate. In males, pelvic fins bear jaspers. They have internal fertilization and many of them are viviparous. Examples: Scolia john, dogfish, Priscus sawfish, Carcharodon is great white shark, and Trigon is stingray. 4.2.11.3 Class Osteichthyes. It includes both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton. Their body is streamlined. Mouth is mostly terminal. Figure 4.20. They have four pairs of gills which are covered by an operculum on each side. The skin is covered with cycloid ctenoid scales. Air bladder is present which regulates buoyancy. Heart is two chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. They are Cold-blooded animals, sexes are separate, fertilization is usually external, they are mostly oviparous and development is direct. Examples include marine exocetus, flying fish, hippocampus, seahorse, freshwater, labia, rahu, katla, clarias, magur, aquarium, betta, fighting fish, pterophyllum, angelfish. Four point 2.11.4 class amphibia. As the name indicates, Greek word amphi means dual and bios means life. Amphibians can live in aquatic as well as terrestrial habitats. Figure 4.21. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. Their bodies divisible into head and trunk. Tail may be present in some. The amphibian skin is moist without scales. Their eyes have eyelids. A tympanum represents the ear, alimentary canal, urinary and reproductive tract open into a common chamber called cloaca, which opens to the exterior. Respiration is by gills, lungs, and through skin. The heart is three chamber, two auricles, and one ventricle. These are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. They are oviparous, and development is indirect. Examples: Beaufortoad, Trana frog, Hyla tree frog, Salamandra salamander, Ichthyopus limbless amphibia. 4.2.115 class amphibia. The class name refers to their creeping or crawling mode of locomotion, Latin repair or reptum, or to creep or crawl. They are mostly terrestrial animals and their bodies covered by dry and conified skin. Epidermal scales or scutes. They do not have external ear openings. Tympanum represent ear. Limbs when present are two pairs. Heart is usually three chambered but four chambered in crocodiles. Reptiles are poikilotherms. Snakes and lizards shed their scales and as skin cast. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is indirect. Examples: Chelon, turtle, testudo, tortoise, chameleon, tree lizard, calotes, garden lizard, crocodile, alligator, hemidactylus, wall lizard, poisonous snakes, naja, cobra, bangaras, krait, vipra, viper. 4.2.116 class A's. That characteristic features of A's birds are the presence of feathers, and most of them can fly except flightless birds. Example: ostrich. They possess beak. Figure 4.23. The forelimbs are modified into wings. The hind limbs generally have the scales and are modified for walking, swimming, or clasping the tree branches. The skin is dry without glands except the oil gland at the base of the tail. Endoskeleton is fully ossified, bony, and the long bones are hollow with air cavities. Pneumatic. The digestive tract of bird has additional chambers, the crop and gizzard. Heart is completely four chambered. They are warm blooded homoiothermous animals, that is, they are able to maintain a constant body temperature. Respiration is by lungs. Air sacs connected to lungs supplement respiration. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Examples: Corvus, crow, columba, pigeon, sitacula, parrot, strutio, ostrich, pavo, peacock, aptenodytes, penguin, neophron, vulture. 4.2.117 class mammalia. They are found in variety of habitats: polar ice caps, deserts, mountains, forests, grasslands, and dark caves. Some of them have adapted to fly or live in water. The most unique mammalian characteristic is the presence of milk-producing gland, mammary gland, by which the young ones are nourished. They have two pairs of limbs adapted for walking, running, climbing, burrowing, swimming, or flying. The skin of mammals is unique in possessing hair. External ears or pinnae are present. Different types of teeth are present in the jaw. Heart is four chambered. They are homoiothermous. Respiration is by lungs. Sexes are separate and fertilization is internal. They are viviparous with few exceptions and development is indirect. Examples: oviparous, ornithorhynchus, platypus, viviparous, macropus, kangaroo, pteropus, flying fox, camelus, camel, macaca, monkey, rattus, rat, canis, dog, felis, cat, elephas, elephant, equus, horse, dolphinus, common dolphin, Balaenoptera, blue whale, Panthera, tigris, tiger, Panthera, leo, lion. The salient distinguishing features of all phyla under animal kingdom is comprehensively given in table 4.2. The basic fundamental features such as level of organization, symmetry, cell organization, coelom, segmentation, notochordate, etc. have enabled us to broadly classify the animal kingdom besides the fundamental features. There are many other distinctive characters which are specific for each phyla or class. Porphyra includes multicellular animals which exhibit cellular level of organization and have characteristic flagellated coanocytes. The coelenterates have tentacles and bear nidoblasts. They are mostly aquatic, sessile or free-floating. The tenophores are marine animals with complates. The platyhelminths have flat body and exhibit bilateral symmetry. The parasitic forms show distinct suckers and hooks. Escalmentis are pseudocolymates and include parasitic as well as non-parasitic roundworms. Annelids are metamerically segmented animals with a true coelom. The arthropods are the most abundant group of animals characterized by the presence of jointed appendages. The mollusks have a soft body surrounded by an external calcareous shell. The body is covered with external skeleton made of chitin. The echinoderms possess a spiny skin. Their most distinct feature is the presence of water vascular system. The hemichordates are a small group of worm-like marine animals. They have a cylindrical body with proboscis collar and trunk. Phylum Chordata includes animals which possess a notochord either throughout or during early embryonic life. Other common features observed in the chordates are the dorsal hollow nerve cord and paired pharyngeal gill slits. Some of the vertebrates do not possess jaws and agantha, whereas most of them possess jaws gnathostomata. Agantha is represented by the class Cyclostomata. They are the most primitive chordates and are ectoparasites on fishes. Gnathostomata has two superclasses, Pisces and Tetrapoda. Classes Conductus and Osteichthyes bear fins for locomotion and are grouped under Pisces. The Conductus are fishes with cartilaginous endoskeleton and are marine. Classes Amphibia, Reptilia, Apes and Mammalia have two pairs of limbs and are thus grouped under Tetrapoda. The amphibians have adapted to live both on land and on water. Reptiles are characterized by the presence of dry and conified skin. Limbs are absent in snakes, fishes, amphibians and reptiles are poikilothermous, cold-blooded. Apes are warm-blooded animals with feathers on their body and four limbs modified into wings for flying. Hind limbs are adapted for walking, swimming, perching and or clasping. The unique features of mammals are the presence of mammary gland and hairs on the skin. They commonly exhibit viviparity. So guys, this was the reading of this chapter. I would be uploading the ARS flashcards and the Allen's handbooks of the same chapter in a short duration.